A new dress, a facelift for the ages, but inside it is still full of red, filled with fervor for the Nebraska Cornhuskers. The Cornhuskers, stung some by missing the Big 12 title in successive years, looking to make a statement in the final year of the century. Nebraska has won 97 games in the decade of the 90s, making the Big Red faithful a happy lot. The opposition, the California Golden Bears, aiming to plant themselves among the winning teams in 99, led by a defense that'll paint your hat. And there are two young quarterbacks, a sophomore and a freshman, who are just learning to shave. When they say go Big Red in this stadium, they mean it. Both California and Nebraska won their opening games last week over Rutgers and Iowa, respectively, and this matchup brings together two very good defenses. Hello again, everybody. I'm Keith Jackson, and welcome to the land of the red, the home of the Nebraska Cornhuskers in the capital city of Nebraska, Lincoln. Memorial Stadium today full for a 228th consecutive time. And we welcome for a 13th consecutive year here on ABC's College Football, the father of Brian Greasy, Bob.
Welcome back. Short retirement, huh?
Well, cowardice entered into it. I've never been unemployed before.
Too many honeydews.
With a redshirt sophomore and a true freshman at quarterback, California is going to be seasoned today by the Nebraska defense. Where are the Bears going to get offense?
Well, this offense last year was one of the worst in the nation. Tom Homo, the coach of the Cal Bears, told me that a defensive back by the name of Delta O'Neill is his best player on the team. Last week, he ran back an interception 75 yards for a touchdown. He took the opening kickoff 50 yards. He's a defensive player that hopes to get 15 to 20 plays on offense. He needs to play well on offense and special teams to help this team win today.
So more and more players are showing up both ways these days, aren't they?
Sure.
Nebraska now, their offense stumbled around some, slow to get started at Iowa last week, and California brings in here a pretty good defensive team themselves.
Darn good defense. Maybe the best defense in the Pac-10, and I think what you're going to see from Frank Solich today, who calls the plays, is a more wide-open type of offense. I think you're going to see passes early, down the field, both quarterbacks in at the same time. A little razzle-dazzle, a few gimmicks. He's going to open it up here in the home opener.
So today we've got a pair of old-timers in the annals of college football. California's been playing the game for 117 years. Nebraska for 109 years. Huskers won the toss, deferred. California will have the football first. Dan Haydenfelt will kick it off for Nebraska. All three of his kickoffs last week went for touchbacks. The deep people for the University of California are LaShawn Ward, 24, Delta O'Neill, number 8. O'Neill is the man they want to get the football if Haydenfelt doesn't kick it beyond the field of play. That's a deep one. It will not be returned. It'll be California ball, first down at the 20 on a brand new playing surface here at Memorial Stadium. More on it from our sideline reporter, Todd Harris.
Well, Keith, it may look like grass. It may not actually feel like grass, but it's not. It's a synthetic turf. It's not like the old AstroTurf shortcut. What they do is they lay this stuff down, and then they dump in this sand, chewed up rubber compost. It works its way into it, and I've talked to all the players on both sides. They say it feels just like grass. One note, though, California, this is the first time they have ever worked out or played on it. This morning they got here, I talked to a few of the players. They are wearing the exact same cleat they wear at home on natural grass. Coach Frank Solich and Coach Charlie McBride, good sports they are. They called Coach Tom Homo and said, do yourself a favor, bring two pairs of shoes just in case. Back to you, Keith.
So the ball game starts on a little bit of a sour note. We have a personal foul called on the Nebraska Cornhuskers on the kickoff. And so the California Golden Bears will come out. They want to be golden again, I'll tell you that. There were times when they truly were, and under the Pappy Waldorf regime and going back to Andy Smith and all of those people back in the 20s, 30s, 40s, and 50s, they want some of that glory back. This is a chance to step up today from the 35-yard line. It goes to Marcus Fields. He almost got to the outside, and if he had broken it outside, he'd still be running. Mike Brown made the tackle for Nebraska. Here now is your starting lineup. for the California Golden Bears. Chile starting lineup. Reed Deal along the left side of the line is going to be very busy today trying to keep his quarterback upright. And John Romero anchors that line at center. Wide receivers, Michael Ainsworth is a freshman, but he's a good one. Give you the backs in a moment. Second down and a long one. You see the quarterback is Samuel Clemens. That sounds familiar. It should, as he comes up across the 45 and a first down at the 47-yard line. For the University of Nebraska defense now, and they call them the Black Shirts. Steve Warren is the anchor. It's going to be fun to watch Warren, a great big guy, 305, matched up against 320-pound John Romero. The linebackers, there are six of them that play those positions for Nebraska. Playing against those guys is like running through a volley of 105 millimeters. Mike Brown and Ralph Brown are the leaders in a very good defensive secondary. And here the Black Shirts step up and make a hit on Marcus Fields. Clint Finley came up from the defensive secondary to make the initial hit on him. He is a 205-pound junior from Cuero, Texas.
California, Keith, would like to get some kind of a running game going just to protect their young quarterbacks, Clemens and Bowler.
They will need it because you let Nebraska defense start loading up on one position and they'll eat your lunch.
Yeah, you don't want to have to throw the football.
Absolutely. Here goes Fields again, slashing over the left side, gets the ball across midfield to about the 49, and he runs into Carlos Polk, linebacker in the middle.
Yeah, number 96, Steve Warren.
And now here are today's Dell Game Solutions.
Well, for California, they need big plays from O'Neill, both on special teams and on offense. Defensively, they need to slow down the Nebraska's big red machine.
Third down and long now. Third and six for the Bears. Here comes your first pass of the day, probably. Three wideouts on the field. Ball goes to the sidelines. It is dropped. Ralph Brown had it right in his hands and nothing but artificial grass between him and Hallelujah Land, and he dropped the ball. So the Bears will punt, and they've got a good one.
Here he is right here. He's just going to try and throw it out there. Brown stays on the outside, doesn't go deep with the receiver, and you see he's trying to throw to the short out. Well, that was six there, Keith.
Nick Harris in the punt now, big fella, and he is a real good one. He set a California record in 97 with 77. Last year had 87 punts. He puts it up where it gets wet among the raindrops, and he can hit that ball downtown.
He's a real weapon. A real weapon.
Kills it down around the 6-yard line, a 43-yard punt, and no return. Now the Chile starting lineup for the Nebraska's offense. Great history along the offensive line, and this group has worked doubly hard to prove their worth in the offseason. Some of them actually took off some weight. The wide receivers, number 3, Matt Davison, gained some fame with that catch at Missouri in 97. Nebraska tight ends may make some big catches today. Quarterback competition is very intense here between Bobby Newcomb and Eric Crouch, and they'll both be on the field at the same time some today. They run it. And he'll be short of the line of scrimmage, stopped at about the 3-yard line as the California Bears defense, Siku Sanyika, makes the first hit on D'Angelo Evans. The defense is anchored by a 310-pound tackle named Jerry DeLoach, but it is the California linebacking core, like Nebraska's, that can really destroy you. All three of these guys can play football.
Maybe the best group in the nation.
Absolutely. And Delta O'Neill is an all-purpose kind of guy in that secondary and the key cover man for the Golden Bears. Willie Miller tries it in the middle. Willie is the fullback and looking to emulate the feats of the Makavica brothers in times past here at Nebraska.
Those two were pretty good fullbacks. Joel Makavica and his brother before him.
It is 68 degrees. It's almost autumnal this afternoon. It's been very warm, but clouds have come in and there's some rain down in the panhandle. So we expect we'll see some later on in the evening, but not during the game, we hope. Third down and long. Third and eight, and the ball is thrown to the sidelines by Bobby Newcomb, intended for Matt Davison, defended by Delpha O'Neill. They'll get well acquainted this afternoon, yeah, I'm sure. And it's punting time.
And Bobby, you better be careful when you're throwing that ball out there on O'Neill, because he is looking for big plays. We talked about him in the opening. He returned an interception last week for a touchdown against Rutgers. He is going for the big plays. There is no question about it.
Harris put it down on the six. The defense held him there. Nebraska's got a punt out of the end zone, and O'Neill is waiting just beyond midfield. Good field position possibility here for California. A low driving kick. It is fielded back at the 35, back to the 30. Looks for daylight, finds a crack. Penalty flag, cross midfield, down to the 46-yard line. But you're probably going to get a push in the back call against California.
Yeah, and the thing about it is, Keith, that you really didn't need to push in the back, because O'Neill was already past where the penalty happened. This kid, O'Neill, was a running back in high school, and his first 2 years at California was a running back. Look at the bottom of the screen right there. That's the wide receiver Ainsworth, number 3.
First down, California.
It's an all Big 12 officiating crew. The referee is Terry Turlington. So we've got our britches dirty now, and we're getting ready to play some serious football. Goes to work from their own 31-yard line. They would have been on the Nebraska side of the field had it not been for a push in the back on the kick return.
That offense was last year's offense. A lot of the players from that offense are back. 7 starters are back from that offense. And the quarterback is new and very young.
Got a new offensive line coach, though. I suspect he's going to have an impact.
Ed White. That'd be a big one.
Down behind the line of scrimmage. The defensive surge by the Nebraska Cornhuskers, led by Steve Warren and Lauren Kaiser.
Here's a look at the pit from behind. Polk is 13. Steve Warren is the nose man. He is over 300 pounds. You normally don't see defensive linemen that heavy. Offensive linemen, yes, not defense.
Second down and 12 for California. Clemens back looking to throw it. Goes down the sideline over the head of the intended receiver. No real chance. Penalty flag comes out of the pocket of the man on the sidelines. Pass intended for Joel Young. Let's see if aggressiveness is going to be foiled here. Against the Huskers.
Look at the protection. Well, I didn't see anything there.
The ball wasn't catchable.
Well, they still had to have to say something. The only thing that they could call there was the defensive back cutting off the path of the wide receiver as he goes downfield.
Just outside the 44-yard line, first down and 10 for California. Clemens rolls, play action, passes away. Pass is caught short by Ainsworth. He's inside the 45 and down at about the 43 before Craver makes the hit for the Huskers. Field turf, they call it. It's artificial. Not quite as firm, perhaps, as Mother Earth, but a very comfortable surface to play on.
This is what Nebraska did last week against Iowa. Defensively allowed no points and only 8 first downs.
And this is first down Bears at the 43. Clemens hands the ball inside the Fields. Fields is 6'2 and about 215 pounds. A junior out of Stockton, brought down by Tony Ortiz and Steve Warren.
Those two defensive tackles in there for Charlie McBride's Huskers are really controlling the middle. Warren and Kaiser had big days last week and continue to shine today. And there's a look at Charlie.
There's another one that's going to retire. Every time I see him, he's going to retire.
Yeah. Yeah. You guys are talking about retirement. You know, nobody believes you anymore.
Second down and 10. Ball is caught. Michael Ainsworth, who's a pretty good size receiver, 6'1", 190, a redshirt freshman out of Monrovia, making the catch, and they can move the chains again. Tonight on ABC, primetime college football, the UCLA Bruins will be at the Horseshoe in Columbus, Ohio. Bruins looking to get things going, but they're without 11 players suspended. Ohio State coming off a loss. There'll be some head knocking in that one. In the ACC tonight, Georgia Tech and Florida State. That's a game that will echo all year long in the ACC. And it begins at 8 Eastern, 5 Pacific here on ABC Sports as Marcus Fields carries again for California and picks up a couple of yards.
Lauren Kaiser, number 91, again getting in there, deep penetration. These two defensive tackles are a load, both right around 300 pounds.
Salim Muhammad, number 34 now, has come in at the tailback position for California. They've got a double wide at the top of the screen. Clemens has some time, now tucks it in and takes off. That's a pretty good run by Clemens, and he is close to a first down. He made three men miss him. Ralph Brown finally got him.
That was a great move by the young quarterback Clemens. Last week, he only played two series, was pulled after two delay of games and a sack. This time, he looks downfield, doesn't make a big mistake, avoids a couple of tacklers, and does a nice job of getting up and almost picking up a first down.
Joshua White had a pretty good block in there for him as well. So it is third down now and short three and a penalty flag against California. Well, this is what got Clemens in trouble last week. He had successive penalties on
delay of game, but that's not a delay of game.
This is not a delay of game.
Dead ball, illegal substitution on the offense, 5-yard penalty.
Yeah,
that's on the bench.
That's not his fault.
That's on the coach.
Here's some of the problems they had last week with their young quarterbacks. We have a sophomore and a true freshman. Five sacks. Everybody contributed to that one, but you're going to struggle when you have young quarterbacks.
It is third and eight as the ball comes back to the 25. Muhammad in the backfield. Clemens gets it away. Ball is caught by Ainsworth. He's tackled. Oh, they missed him, and he keeps tumbling forward and gets a first down for California at the Nebraska 14-yard line. Craver hit him, but didn't really take him down.
This is great effort, Keith, by the quarterback Samuels. I mean, Clemens, and Ainsworth. He goes down, breaks in, comes back to the outside. Now he's got to pick up the first down, avoids the first tackler and the second, and picks up the first down.
Ainsworth has made three third down catches for California, all of them getting first downs for them. So they're inside the 15, at the 14. Here's a penalty flag again. Thrown right into the pile, so somebody will probably hold it. Yep. And it's the offense.
See, that's a killer. The penalty before this, the illegal substitution, made it third and eight when it was only like third and two or three. And now this one moves them back 10 yards further.
The offense, 10-yard penalty, still first down.
We mentioned earlier that this offense of California was one of the worst in the nation last year. And when you're trying to build that up, you can't hurt yourself and stop yourself going against a great defense like Nebraska.
No, the black shirts don't need any help.
No, they don't need it. Help.
First down and 20 now for California. They spread them out with three wides. Single back. And down goes Clemens on a sack. Back on the 31-yard line. Jeremy Schlechter.
Had nobody open downfield, and this is what happens when you get into pure passing situations. The 10-yard holding penalty forced the Bears to do this. They're not good at doing this. The receivers weren't open, the quarterback sat in the pocket, and you can't hold this defensive line out. Select doing a nice job of sacking the quarterback.
The fella in there at the tailback position now for California is number 29, Joe Igber. He's a freshman from Honolulu, and he is exciting, and he's got the ball. He just keeps on wiggling. You have to take a stick to him to get him down. He's close to the 25-yard line.
You got to take a stick and beat him. Charlie McBride yesterday, the coordinator for the Huskers, was telling me when he comes in the game, look for the draws. Exactly what they ran. They ran a draw play. He is exciting. He stops and moves. People say he looks a lot like Barry Sanders' style of running. Stop and go.
They were looking for him, and he still got something out of it. Underneath to Igberg. Oh, good tackle.
Oh, great
good
play.
Good tackle by Carlos Polk.
Great play by Polk, or he's gone.
He had the people downfield. He would might very well have scored if Polk doesn't get it.
Here it is. Here, Keith. They're going to screen out this way. Now watch as this develops. Look to the right side over here as it's going to develop. Slowly it's developing, but it's going to come. Little screen. Now look at all the yellow shirts. No red shirts over there. And Polk, with his speed, just gets over there and makes the play.
35-yard field goal try by Ignacio Brache. And it is no good. The senior from Sun Valley misses from 35. So we 5:16 to play in the first quarter. And we are scoreless in Lincoln. Second year as the head man and offensive coordinator for Nebraska. And you made the point last week, same one you made when he took the job. Succeeding Tom Osborne as the offensive coordinator is the real chore.
Yeah.
You got a feel for it. You got to get a rhythm for it. And it takes time.
Look out here. He could go deep.
Hand it inside. ABC Sports presentation of college football brought to you by Ford Motor Company. Better ideas. Chili's, a proud sponsor of ABC's college football. State Farm Insurance, like a good neighbor, State Farm is there. And Nike. Second down.
Keith, California has run 15 plays. Nebraska has only run 4.
Took him to the sidelines, bounces the ball in front of the receiver, John Gibson. And now let's check in with our studio in New York, John Saunders.
Keith, the Fighting Irish of Notre Dame coming off a very disappointing loss to Michigan. Here on your Win Your Way Burger King update, facing Purdue today. Jarius Jackson, who almost led the upset of Michigan, here takes off 15 yards for the touchdown, part of a 10-0 lead for the Irish. Still 5 minutes to go in the first quarter. Keith.
Third down, long 8, short 9, if you like. Setting up a screen. Newcomb is taken down inside the 5-yard line by Andre Carter, who was relentless in his pursuit. A defensive end. They're trying to set a screen. The Bears infiltrated. They couldn't get what they wanted. Newcomb kept retreating, and now the Huskers will have to punt it out of the end zone.
Carter's father, Reuben, played for the Denver Broncos for quite a long time and also a couple years with the Miami Dolphins.
Where he came from, Florida State, didn't he?
Yep. No. Oh.
No, Miami? Somewhere down here.
I don't think so.
He sure was a good one. I know that. Way back out of the back of the end zone. Oh, look at this. Holy smokes, what a punt. Bounces away from O'Neill. There will be no return. The ball is inside the 25-yard line. That is a 83 yards approximately on that punt. No, it can't be that. It'll be 73 yards on the kick. Just had his career best punt, 77 yards for the record. From where he hit the ball, 6 yards behind the line of scrimmage, 83 yards.
Well, and out of his own end zone, too.
Wow. Some kick. It is Nebraska nothing and California nothing in Lincoln. And we have 3:44 to play in the first quarter. California with the ball from the 23-yard line. Give it away to Marcus Fields. And he tries the middle and gets something out of it, about 4, maybe 5. Julius Jackson, another of those six or seven linebackers that play there for Nebraska, making that tackle. The old lady has a new look this year, some fancy. I mean, this is one of the great facilities for football in all the world. Now, after the remodeling, spent some $36 million. Athletic director Bill Byrne has really done some things since he came from the West. And you know what? It's virtually all paid for. That's, oh my goodness. He is lucky to get that back. Chris Kelsey. Boom.
Kelsey may have knocked that down. He may have knocked down an interception because the corner was sitting all over that one.
Kraber was just sitting there waiting for it, wasn't he?
22, Ralph Brown is over here on this side. There you see right there, Ralph, at the bottom of your screen. Those short outs on Ralph Brown. He's one of the best corners in the country.
All right, Cal up now on third down and five. Clemens lets it go to the sideline. Good pass, but the defender got a hand in there and spoiled it for Joel Young. And the guy defending on the play is number 50, a linebacker, Julius Jackson.
Well, Jackson had the underneath coverage. He was just kind of trailing him. Jackson, number 50, right there. He's just going to trail him. Now, Jackson knows he's got deep help from Brown, number 21. He does a nice job there. When the receiver goes to catch it, he sticks his arm out. Big play.
Nebraska people can run. You can't play football here if you can't run, no matter what your position. Low snap. Harris gets it out all right. Didn't get all of it. It's kind of wiggling down the field. And look at this. Dewan Gross spinning away to the inside. Gets a nice return out of it. And the ball comes up near midfield. 36-yard punt and a 13-yard return.
Gross is a redshirt freshman playing this year for the first time and returning kicks for the first time. This is the best field position by far for the Nebraska Huskers.
And they come up without a huddle. Come right off the sidelines and right to the ball at their own 49-yard line. No score in the first quarter, 2:50 to go. Newcomb gets pressure. Got him back at the 42-yard line. Tuesday, September 21st. It's the most shocking Dharma and Greg you'll ever see. We suggest you don't miss the season premiere Tuesday. 43 on the spot, where they will have it now. Second down and 16.
The defensive line for California is dominating the offensive line of scrimmage right now.
Coming down the line, a little play action, not going the other way. Newcomb's got some open field. He can run. He's got Nebraska's first down of the day. And there's a penalty flag following the play. That may very well go against Cal and really put Nebraska in their first position of opportunity.
Yeah, no question. Bobby Newcomb, the quarterback position, the wild card position in Solich's offense, because they can run. If the play breaks down, they take off running.
Personal foul on the defense. 15-yard penalty. Automatic first down.
This play is defensed well, the defensive line and everything else. Right here, Bobby Newcomb says, I'm avoiding the defensive end. Now I'm a running back. Now, it's not the first guy right here. This is a good hit right there. But it's when the defensive back comes back, that's DeStefano.
We've got time taken for an injured California Bear.
Right there.
And it's Jacob Wasdorp, a tackle inside, who has finally, for just now, stepped up and is coming off the field. And Matt Beck was also hurt on that last play as well. So they lose two horses in the middle of their defensive unit.
Well, you got that right, Hoss. Two horses.
Put the ball on the 20-yard line where it's a first down for Nebraska.
Look out for Wistrom here. They got the tight end. They go sitting right in the middle of the end zone.
Newcomb close to the 15. Well, you know, DeStefano likes to play, the free safety likes to play around the line of scrimmage, and he leaves center field open.
All the safeties were up the line of scrimmage. Deep middle was open. I don't know how much freedom the offensive coaches for Nebraska give the quarterbacks, but if they had a checkoff to get somebody in the middle of the field, it was there.
Juan Jimenez, a junior out of Los Angeles, is in at that middle line, that linebacking position for Beck right now. They're looking at Beck's foot. Just short of the 15-yard line for Nebraska. Their first real threat of the day. And this is Newcomb keeping. And being dragged down from behind by Sanyika as he gets to about the 12-yard line.
.13 at the bottom of your screen is Sekou Sanyika. He's one of the best linebackers in the country. There's a ton of tackles behind the line of scrimmage. You won't get many against this team. This team is too quick.
Third down and a long two now for the Huskers at the California 12-yard line. Hillback hasn't seen it much today on the option. He fakes it to Evans, keeps it, turns it, and scores! Touchdown run for Bobby Newcomb.
Watch, he's take the option, go right down the line. 13 is Sanyika. He's got to play the pitch man. He gets faked out by Newcomb. Miller's looking for somebody to block. Newcomb says, get out of my way, Willie. I'm going home.
Josh Brown for the extra point. It's good. And the balloons go sailing toward the heavens. All of them red, of course, as the Nebraska Cornhuskers, ranked number 6 in the nation, take a 7-0 lead with 28 seconds to play in the first quarter. 5 plays, 51 yards in that drive. And on that possession, they picked up their initial first down of the afternoon.
This is a tough defense. Last year, when this game was played out in Cal, Nebraska had a tough time scoring. The score was only like 24-3 or 7 at the end of the game, but they had a tough time scoring against this defense. There's a look at Eric Crouch. I'm sure he got the call. The first 3 series belong to Bobby Newcomb. This kid can play. Here's a look at a comparison of last week. The big thing last week, the turnovers. Bobby Newcomb had 3 turnovers and Crouch didn't have any. Newcomb had a lot more plays, 51-18.
California's got to watch out now that Nebraska doesn't build up a big head of steam. This is O'Neill. He's dangerous. And he's out across the 25 and tripped up. Otherwise, he'd have had another 10 or 12 yards.
He is excitement. He can run and he can make tacklers miss.
17 seconds remaining in the first quarter.
Keith, I think it's interesting that when Steve Mariucci was the coach here at Cal several years ago, that Delta O'Neill, Mariucci was an offensive coach. Delta played offense for 2 years. When Tom Homo came in, who's a defensive coach, he moved O'Neill over to defense. He says, I want you on my side over here.
Marcus Fields is the deep man. Joshua will bite in front of him, and it is Fields with the ball, penalty flag. He may very well have another holding call coming up here.
Fields brought down on the play.
Yep.
O'Neill wants to play some offense, and Steve Hagan, the offensive coordinator, would like to get him like 20 to 25 snaps per game on offense. Banged up his thumb last week a little bit, so we don't know exactly how much we're going to see of it.
Still first down.
A moment with Todd Harris.
He doesn't have a shoe on, and they're taking him in possibly for x-rays, but he looks like he might be done for the day.
That's Matt Beck that Todd's talking about. Audio came up late, but Beck, number 99, is leaving the field with his shoe off, and Todd may very well be right that Matt Beck is done for the day. Boy, is that close.
Yeah, he's the leader of that defense.
So we've played one in Lincoln, and after 15 minutes, it's the home team. Nebraska leading California by a score of 7-0. Cool day. 68 degrees when we started. It's been in the 80s all week long, but very cool today. But the boys have been out there thrashing around, feel the need for the cool zone to calm their fettered brow. California ball, first down and 20. Ball is back at their own 19-yard line as we start the second quarter of play. Nebraska leading 7-0. And the ball carrier is Marcus Field. He has a gain of a couple of yards on the play to make it second down and 18. The crowd today is a record for Memorial Stadium. The stadium was expanded from 72,700 to 74,031. And the crowd today is 77,617. Samuel Clemens getting backside pressure, gets his pass off down the sidelines, and the ball comes out. The receiver, Ronnie Davenport, had it on his hands, but he couldn't hold on. The Brown brothers were there.
And just good coverage, Keith. As you mentioned, both Brown brothers are there. Sam throws the ball as well as you can throw it. Number 9, both the Brown brothers.
Yeah, right really, there. Not really brothers. We probably ought not to say that because one's from Arizona and one's from California.
You're right. They're not related. They're not related. The Brown boys, I should say.
Clemens is now 4 of 8 for 46 yards. He's missed his last 3. Out of the shotgun. Quickly away down the middle. It's bobbled and finally caught by number 87, Brian Surgener, the tight end. He's still short of the first down, however, and the punting unit will have to come on. Now then, with a little bit of breeze at his back, I want to see what Nick Harris, if he gets all of it, can do with it. Because we saw a 77-yarder a while ago from Hayden Cup. And Harris is fully capable of the same kind of heroics. Gross and Craver have gone deep for Nebraska. Low snap. Got it out. Got some air under it. That's a pretty good one. Inside, a hit on the 4-yard line and went into the end zone, and it's a 65-yard punt. So I got a hunch we're going to see some big ones going right to left.
You got that right.
Timeout, 7-0 Huskers. Well, first down at their own 20-yard line, and Eric Crouch is now in at quarterback for the Huskers. Those are the numbers from last week. He comes off the bench foaming at the mouth.
You got that right. This is they don't lose anything when Eric Crouch comes in the ball game, to be sure.
The eye back for Nebraska, Evans, D'Angelo Evans, has not seen the ball much today. But he's out there, lest you forget. They'll give it to him. 3 wide outs. Crouch hands to Evans. Evans finds a little room over the left side and will get 4 yards. And here is a penalty flag thrown to the linesman running in from the sideline.
It's got to be a late hit. These are the silly mistakes that if you're a team like Cal on the road, Nebraska doesn't need any help.
Personal foul on the defense. 15-yard penalty. First down.
Take a look at last week. Eric Crouch faked a little pitch. That's the first touchdown against Iowa. Now he runs like a halfback or a fullback right there. You talk to defensive coordinators that have to go up against this Nebraska offense, and you start talking about Eric Crouch, and they just shake their head.
California penalties 6 times now for 65 yards. Ball is pitched back to D'Angelo Evans, and he is caught and dragged down. Somebody wrapped his feet at about the 37-yard line. Jacob Wasdorp. Jacob came out shaken up, but he's back in there. Matt Beck, who was hurt on the same play, is gone. He's in the clubhouse.
Well, a little bit of good news for California. Jacob Wasdorf, as Keith pointed out, is back on the field. He had a severe stinger. They held him out for a few series. Matt Beck, however, the trainer told me he went in. The foot is a real issue. They're going to x-ray it. He may be done, but they aren't canceling anything out.
All right, Hart Harris, thank you very much.
We got a BYU Cougar working on the sideline with us this year. Here goes Crouch around the corner. And he'll move it out to about the 44-yard line before Damian Marzette tracks him down. Now time for the Aflac trivia question. This week we'll... Let's see. What do these teams have in common? That's a bunch of heavyweights in college football. What do they have in common? We'll be back with the answer for you in a couple of minutes. Yard line, third down, and five. Oh, they picked off that one man coming from the backside. The ball is thrown deep. Tracy Westrom, the tight end. I told you a little while ago, the free safety likes to play around the line of scrimmage, and it leaves center field open, and Nebraska just cast it for 32 yards. Yes, he's the younger brother of Grant, who terrorized folks around here for several years as a defensive man, and he's starting for the Rams tomorrow.
Tight end is going to sneak down the middle of the field. This is where it's going to be open. Play action pass, get him up on the option. Wester makes a great play.
And it's the first Nebraska pass completed today. Up the middle, Bidhole. That's an 8-yard pickup by Eric Crouch.
Things happen when Eric Crouch comes into the ball game. Defensive coordinators say he throws the ball accurately. He runs with power and speed. And Frank Solich says he may be our fastest guy on the team. He turns it up. Remember, we saw him last year, Keith. He was filling in. Injured some. We saw him at Kansas State. And he was a big-time player then, but he's got more confidence now.
Second down and two. There he goes. He's got his first down as he turns it to the 10-yard line. Siku Sanyika and Pete DiStefano made the tackle for the Bears. We have Crouch in the game for his first series now for Nebraska. We're anticipating that we'll see Kyle Bowler pretty soon because he's down on the sidelines warming up now. He does not, however, have his hat on.
Bowler, the true freshman quarterback of California, their biggest recruit in almost, what, two decades?
Well, he's certainly been hyped. I know him. He's from Newhall, Hart High School, and he was a terrific player, the California State Player of the Year. The ball to the corner. That's got to get a flag. That'll get a flag. Chidi Nwomu ran into Tracy Westrom. Westrom was there, and the woman went over and banged him. And it's actually, in this case, probably a good penalty because Westrom was in there for 6 points. There are, once in a while, good fouls.
Yeah, that's for sure. Well, he had a choice of guys who could have hit. He had two guys open. One, the opposite, he's going to get, this is one receiver, and the other guy is going to be in the middle as he comes down. The option comes this way and holds the defensive backs. It's going to go down, and they're both going to break. If you can stop it right here, you can see this man is open, more so than the man that he threw it to.
Yep. So it is first and goal now, Nebraska at the California 2-yard line. There's the play, and you see, that's an easy one. I could call that.
Well, you got your laundry with you?
Yep, I bought it just in case. They stack him up in the backfield, and the ball is kept by Crouch, and he is stopped short of the glory land by Keith Miller, who's come back from injury. Keith Miller's a very good football player. He was the leading tackler in the win last week against Rutgers.
He's like, he's the third guy, those three linebackers in there, Beck and Sanyika. He's the one that gets the none of the notoriety or no publicity or anything. He's like Mac Morrison for Penn State. Penn State's got a great group of linebackers.
Ball is just almost touching the 1-yard hash mark. Evans, Miller, and Euler in the backfield, and Nebraska will take a timeout. So the Huskers want to talk about things. We don't want to fritter away an opportunity. It is 9:36 to go in the first half. Sean Applegate. Now, you might want to keep your eye out there looking for number 82, because he set himself up in the backfield. He's that middleman in that stack. See what they do with it. Coming down the line on the option right, quarterback keeps it, sticks his head in there, and didn't make it. He did not get there.
He's not down yet either.
No.
This is a tough kid. Last week he ran over a defensive back. This time he ran into a couple of linebackers.
Delta O'Neill and Jacob Wasdorp are the primary people in making the stop.
This is just a quarterback keeper. He's got the ball tucked away. There's Miller right there.
Yep, Miller.
He's still fighting. He ain't down yet. I don't like to see him lower his head that way, though. Don't.
No.
You young people out there, don't lower your neck like that.
Well, he tried to make a block last week when he was in his wideout and wound up with his chin on the top of his helmet. Everybody riding him all week about that.
Yeah.
On third down, the quarterback keeper, and this time he gets it across the plane. Wasn't easy, but he found a way.
Yeah, it wasn't initially, but his second effort found a gap. Good surge by the Bears, but Crouch just initially he was stopped, but he found a gap to the right and got across.
Both Newcomb and Crouch now have a rushing touchdown for Nebraska. The Huskers trying to make it 14-0 on the extra point, and they do. So with 8 minutes and 44 seconds to play in the first half, it's 14-0 Nebraska. ABC Sports presentation of college football brought to you by the new Chevy Silverado. It's not just any truck, it's the truck. Bud Light, for the great taste that won't fill you up and never let you down, make it a Bud Light.
Both teams have had the ball four times, Keith. Nebraska has scored on their last two touchdowns. California has been three and out on their last two possessions. Touchdown for Newcomb and a touchdown for Crouch.
Haydenfeld will kick it off. Ward settles under it at the 6-yard line. Oh, that's a pretty good return. He brings that thing out across the 35 to the 37-yard line before Taylor Gibbon finally brings him down. So with a 14-0 lead for Nebraska, California gets an opportunity to start from pretty good field position at the 37. They've not been able to maintain any consistency in their attack so far, and as they come onto the field at quarterback, it is still number 5, Samuel Clemens, the redshirt sophomore.
Tom Homo did say that the other quarterback, Bowler, would play. I think he's just going to let it go. And if Clemens is continuing to play well, he'll go with him.
And at 14-0, you're still hanging around. That's a pretty good run by Fields. He gets it across the 40, out to the 42, and picks up almost 5 yards.
The good thing about the Cal running game is it's just barely good enough to make some first downs and to keep the Nebraska offense off the field, and it takes some time off the clock. If he was dropping back and throwing the ball down the field to try to make some big plays, they'd be three and out very quickly.
Marcus Fields now has had 10 carries for 28 yards in the ball game. Got it again. Oh boy, I'll tell you, he ran into trouble that time. Big old number 48, Jamie Burrow, just stood him up and stopped him. All right, now the answer for your Aflac trivia question.
It's an offensive question, by the way. Offensive, you gotta think offense.
What is the answer? They have two quarterback systems. In other words, they have two quarterbacks in competition for the starting job.
Nobody has ever won a national championship using two quarterbacks, and they'll be talking about that. John Saunders and Terry Bowden had it during halftime. So.
Timeout is called by California. So they've got two remaining. Both teams now have two times out remaining at 7:19 to play in the first half. California needs 2 yards if they are to maintain this possession. Ball is just short of the 45-yard line. Samuel Clemens stays in there at tailback. I wonder if he's reading the Mark Twain books. Ainsworth, the man in motion. Batted up in the air and intercepted. Mike Brown made the interception. Steve Warren slapped it into the air. And it's turnover.
Warren gets you a lot of different ways, Keith. Here's Warren. Go ahead, run it. Steve Warren, 96, beats his man, sees what's happening, does the next best thing he can do by getting up, knocks it in the air, and Steve Warren is responsible for this interception. Great play.
And the Huskers are operating now at the California 47-yard line with Bobby Newcomb back in at quarterback, and the ball is thrown deep down the field and incomplete.
Threw it too soon.
And he threw the ball for Eric Crouch, who was in the ball game at wide out, was going to the outside. The ball drifted back inside, and you're right. If he'd have waited, or if he could have waited. Yeah.
This is what we were talking about early in the opening. They have two quarterbacks in the game. Crouch is in the game, and the pressure on the quarterback. See, Crouch breaks back to the outside. Newcomb thought he was going straight down the middle.
Bobby didn't have time to wait because Juan Jimenez was all over him.
Well, that's a gimmick right there. Two quarterbacks in the game. They came out. They didn't show it. They went right to the line of scrimmage. And Newcomb says to Crouch, come on now, you got to run those routes. Don't break those routes off. I got to know where you're going.
There was a flag on the field, if you saw it. That was a sideline warning to the Bears to get back away from the edge of the field where they had been too close, according to the rules. And that time the California defense stands up Newcomb and bring him down after about a yard pickup. Jeremiah Parker, number 95, was involved in the play. There's Jeremiah. A lot of young people playing football for California right now. You got to build a foundation. You got to take the young ones and let them grow some whiskers, and that's what they're doing.
Well, you're right, and you got to let them play. There's Lyle Settencich on the left side. There is done a very good job, and you got to let the freshmen play if they're good enough.
Newcomb brought down. That's a pretty good defensive play by Andre Carter right there. He's a junior out of San Jose.
Well, this Cal team can get after. Defensively, they had 17 tackles behind the line of scrimmage last week against Rutgers. And 7 sacks, so they get after it pretty good.
O'Neill going back deep for California under the punt from Dan Haydenfelt. Got a lot of air under it. Fair catch call. At the 12-yard line. Lights are on in Lincoln because we have a gray overcast day. Rain coming, but not expected until after the game.
I don't think O'Neill has been in on offense yet today.
I haven't seen it. Time to throw, and throws off the hands of Marcus.
He had tons of room. If he would have caught that, he had tons of room to run.
Number 37 was the man in coverage, Tony Ortiz, a linebacker running with a running back. Now that theoretically should be a mismatch. But not always in the case of Nebraska linebacker.
There is nobody around him. If he catches this ball, number 19, the free safety there, Finley, is the closest guy, and he was on the other side of the field.
But It is second and 10. This time Fields has no room, nothing. And we're off to John Saunders in New York.
Keith, Notre Dame and Purdue. And Notre Dame has moved the ball nicely here. They stop Purdue and Danny Rogers going for the punt. Tony Driver with the block. And this would set up Jarius Jackson's second touchdown of the day from a yard out. Now the Irish leading it 16-7. Keith.
I don't know what that was. 14-0, Nebraska leading, and Clemens rolling around. We'll come back the other way. This time Fields catches the ball, gets a first down out of the play, and Findlay, 19, was there this time to help on the tackle with Mike Brown.
Well, they went back to the play, Keith, that was there before, and they missed it. When you have opportunities to make big plays, you got to hit them. Right here, he's going to come over this way. This is the same opportunity that he had earlier. See how open he was? The time before, there was no red shirts around him. This time, there were a few close to it, but they just ran him down.
But they did get a first down, move the chains out to the 35-yard line. At 4 minutes and 35 seconds to play in the first half, Clemens tracked down by Ortiz. Tony looped in from the right side and just ran him down.
You hate to see a quarterback take a sack like that, especially when you're outside the pocket, when you've got a little bit more time and you know where all the trouble is. The coaching point there is to throw it away and not take the sack.
Yeah, but you got to hear those pounding hooves too. And it takes time to learn how to feel that. Loss on the play of about 7 yards.
California's had more plays than Nebraska.
Pick down the middle of the field. It will be incomplete. Almost intercepted by Clint Findlay against LaShawn Ward. Ward running under the ball, but Findlay got there first and had position to actually make the catch, but couldn't.
Findlay is the free safety, and he does a nice job of helping out. Deep middle, you're supposed to be back there helping your corners, and he is.
Lest he face the sternness of one angry Charles McBride. Joe Igber checks into the ball game now for California.
Draw.
Goes in motion.
He's out of there. Screen.
Throw inside underneath, and it's almost picked off. It was bouncing around and finally fell to the ground, and California will have to punt it away.
I tell you, when Igber comes in, there's four red shirts following him around because they know. They know he's going to get the ball. He's a true freshman. He probably only knows a few plays, and they try to get it to him.
Harris has had punts of 43, 36, and 65, and he's still got the wind at his back. Let's see how he roots it this time. Almost got to him. And it is fielded by Gross. And he goes down at about the 27-yard line.
And ball come out?
Ball come out, and California covered it. But where are they going to make the mark? Are they going to put him up there at the 27-yard line? He's in there at quarterback, Dan Alexander. The big back is in at the I back position, has the ball. Had a bit of a sore knee earlier, but he looks all right now, and we'll go to Todd Harris on the sideline.
Well, Keith, moments ago, Matt Beck, the linebacker, came back out on the field. Unfortunately, he is in a sweatsuit. They wouldn't say if he's done for the day or not, but that's a pretty good indication he's not going to be back. They say it's just a sprained foot. They're going to be very cautious with him because he does that defense. The defense right now, they're really focusing on the safeties and corners. They feel like their up front men and middle men are containing Nebraska. It's up to the safeties and corners to turn it into the middle.
If he lights a cigar, Todd, we know he ain't coming back.
Well, anytime you hurt a foot, that's pretty good to sign you're not coming back. Right. Down the middle.
Got him open. Nobody within 30 yards of him. It's Tracy Wistrom, and it's touchdown Nebraska. 70-yard play.
We said that we thought that Solich might open it up a little bit and throw the ball downfield. And he certainly did it there. Point is good
by Josh Brown. That's career-long pass and career-long reception for the people involved in that 70-yarder. Crouch, the quarterback, and Wistrom, the receiver, the tight end. Another look.
There you go, the safeties. DeStefano is right here, and the other one, the two safeties are blitzing all the time. Here's Wistrom straight down the field. Crouch shows the option. First down play, good call, right down the middle of the field. Nobody close to Wistrom. You don't get them that easy. I mean, that's like practice stuff there.
Well, those safeties, I mean, if the quarterback sees both those safeties up there.
Oh, yeah. Well, that was part of the game plan, because the two safeties, Marzette and DeStefano, really make a lot of tackles. So they hit, especially the option teams, sneak the tight end down the middle of the field. Crouch has got a pretty good percentage of series in the ball game and touchdown scored.
That kick is bounding and bounding and staying in bounds, and the Bears have to return it. It's O'Neal coming. Ooh, a little crunch there up to about the 20-yard line. So with 2 minutes and 25 seconds to play in the first half, Nebraska's lead is 21-0. So Clemens stays in and apparently is going to finish the half.
And I think the reason that Tom Homo has decided to stay with Clemens, Keith, is the fact that he's got a true freshman over there on the sideline and is just doesn't want to put him in here in the first half while the game is, you know, still they're still in the ballgame. And Clemens is not doing a bad job.
You got to remember who they're playing. And 18, 19-year-old eyes get pretty wide when you look at the lecture.
And if you come in here and he does poorly, you could set him back,
yep.
You know, right. Confidence-wise for a long time.
I don't know what. I guess they were trying to set up a screen, but
that's dangerous there. Oh.
Fields was just Marcus Fields was buried. He had no way in the world of getting his hands on it because there were five red shirts. There.
That may be the poorest decision that Sam Clemens made all day right there. Should never have thrown that ball. Just because it's a screen and you drop back and you throw to an area, it may not be there. So you have to wait and see. There was nothing there except red shirts. Clemens is 6 of 15 with 84 yards and an interception.
Steve Hagan is the new offensive coordinator on Homo's staff. Came over from San Jose. There's a penalty flag across the way as Joshua White carries the ball. Hagan, he's a quick trigger guy. He's a very emotional coach, and he has no problem of setting somebody on the bench and putting somebody else in. And he was involved in developing offenses at Nevada, Reno, UNLV, then over to San Jose, and now up to California.
Yeah, and last year they had one receiver, Damian Douglas, catch 100 balls. And he said they want to spread it around more. That's too many for one receiver. They want to throw the ball deep down the field more this year also. But this is not a sprint. Tom knows that this is a long process. He's 3-8 his first year. He was 5-6 last year. He's got a good defense and just needs to develop this offense a little bit.
Second down and 15. Better hurry. Throws a wounded goose into the sidelines as he is hit from the backside. And it'll be third down. Julius Jackson and Jason Lohr were the Huskers who were making the quarterback's life miserable on that play.
Yeah. This time everybody's covered and he decides just to get rid of the ball and throws it and barely gets it out of bounds because he was hit just as he was throwing it. Julius Jackson, number 50, is a fifth-year senior. He's a backup linebacker. And they're going to lose four of their top six linebackers to graduation this year. So Charlie McBride's going to have to do a little replacing in linebacker.
Oh, he's got some in the barn. This is Marcus Fields trying to find some daylight, and there
is very little of it. And so California now will have to punt it away on fourth and long. Clemens started in the early going of the game 4 for 5 for 46 yards. But since that time, as Nebraska has adjusted its defense, he's gone 2 for 11 for 38 yards with an interception. So that's called tightening the screws, shutting the doors.
Nebraska can do that on
low kick, returnable. Craver about midfield. Here's a flag on the field.
This could be another late hit.
Big 12 crew, we told you. Terry Turlington is the referee. Push in the back. So let's check in with John and Terry and see what they're going to do at halftime.
Coming up on Valvoline Halftime 99, scores and highlights, including number 2 Penn State in some trouble and major baseball news as well.
And I'm going to take on the NCAA Rules Committee.
It's all coming up on Valvoline Halftime 99.
Penalty puts the ball back on the 40-yard line, where it'll be first down and 10 for Nebraska. We have 1:05 to play in the first half.
You get both quarterbacks in there, Keith.
Newcomb is behind center. Crouch is wide to the bottom of the picture. Running toward the ball now. That puts 2 wide outs on the top side, and Newcomb looks that way. Goes underneath to Crouch. Look out! On his way! Down 60 yards. Mile sentence it said, you have to be careful. If they get going, it's like an avalanche.
The more you watch this offense, the more it seems to me the big play guy is Eric Crouch. They're trying to get the ball to Eric Crouch.
So we won't have any more yipping in the media about the competition at quarterback, I don't think.
I think Eric's getting all the playing time he wants.
That's right.
This time he lined up at flanker, went in motion, and then ran a screen. Going to come across the formation. The offensive line is going to come down, and he's going to just take a little short pass. And the offensive line, Sherman 63, Rayola 54, get downfield to make some blocks. And it looks like Crouch almost ran out of gas there at the end.
Come on, legs, just one more step.
Yeah.
Please, please, please.
Yeah. We kind of knew something was up yesterday in talking with some of the coaches when both the quarterbacks were going to be in there. Rayola, 54, is a big part of that offense. He's a center. Turner, Gill, Crouch.
53 seconds to play in the first half, and Eric, in conversation with us, said that it was not true that he ever, ever considered quitting the football team. He was just disappointed. And he went home.
Well,
think about it.
And rightfully so. I mean, if you were in a competition and they chose the other guy, you'd be disappointed too. But you know, I don't believe in it's a controversy. I think it's a competition.
I agree.
I mean, it's
particularly these two.
Oh, sure.
Controversy is made for the media anyway.
Yeah, it's their word.
That's right.
There's no controversy amongst the players or the coaches.
Nebraska's total yards now beginning to mount. They have 46 running, 2 touchdowns, and 162 passing and 2 touchdowns. And they're leading by a score of 28-0. And California tries to run, get a little bit out of it. And they will. But I think the Bears are going to the clubhouse now without taking any more chances or giving Nebraska any more opportunities.
Well, they're deflated. The strongest part of this California team was their defense. And And they've had touchdowns scored against them on four of the last five possessions by Nebraska.
That's short of the line of scrimmage. Whistle stops it. Joshua White could find no place to go because big old Carlos Polk had him wrapped up. He was like kudzu growing on a pole. I mean, there was no place to go.
Kudzu, huh?
And time runs out at the halftime here at Memorial Stadium in Lincoln, Nebraska. It's the Cornhuskers 28 and the Golden Bears of California struggling. They have a zero. At halftime here in Lincoln at Memorial Stadium, and it's 28-0. The Cornhuskers are leading in a ball game that started at a relatively even pace, and then, boom, a fella named Eric Crouch stepped up and made some plays.
It's been the Eric Crouch show. He has come in and he's run for a touchdown. He's passed for a touchdown, and then he received a touchdown. It was unbelievable the way the quarterbacks for Nebraska seem to be the focus of attention now and not the I-backs.
Well, Newcomb got the first touchdown on a 12-yard run, and he looked more like an old-fashioned tailback out of the single wing doing it. And then here comes the Crouch story.
It's the wide receiver screen. Crouch lined up, went in motion, and then came back and got it in the end zone.
Now, on the previous possession, Eric Crouch had thrown a 70-yard pass to Wistrom.
Here's a look at the touchdowns scored this season. Newcomb has scored five touchdowns, been a part of five. And Crouch has been a part of
all the others.
Six, yeah. And the tailbacks are not the focal point of this team this year. It's been Eric Crouch and Newcomb. And in particular, Crouch. Crouch had a big game last week.
The Morgan Stanley Dean Witter first half stats read this way.
Nebraska passing for 162 yards on two big plays, a touchdown pass to Wistrom and then one to Crouch. We said in the opening that Frank Solich was going to try and open it up with some big plays using both quarterbacks. And we've seen that in the first half.
One of the misleading stats of all time can be time of possession, can't it?
Yeah. Well, that's when Nebraska scores 28 points, that means when they score 28 points that quickly, that means they're not taking long to do it.
A record crowd of 77,617 in the stadium today, and down on the floor of this great big old bowl is Todd Harris.
Thank you, Keith. The word from both coaches, Frank Solich feels pretty good, not overconfident. He just feels good. A few big plays, obviously involving Eric Crouch and Bobby Newcomb. He feels good about his offense and his defense. For Cal, however, Tom Holmoe says, you know what, we're not out of this. He says just a few misreads by his safeties and corners, and they're back in it. You give them that missed field goal and possibly that touchdown that Polk brought down. Who knows? Bad news for them, however, Matt Beck is done for the day, and there may be some more problems on the offensive line. A few stingers taking their toll. Back to you, Keith.
All right, Todd, thank you very much. Let me ask you one more question. You heard anybody say anything, or what's your feeling as you've been down there of this new surface on the stadium? Is it holding up all right?
He says the kids absolutely love it. That's Coach Tom Holmoe. He says no problem with the footing. They didn't make any shoe changes at halftime. The kickers like it. The receivers like it. He's not going to use that as a crutch. He says it's just misreads for their defensive backs. If they get that nailed down, it could be another second half.
All right, Todd. Thanks very much. So California will kick it off to Nebraska to start the second half of play. The Huskers are leading by a score of 28-0. Newcomb scored, Crouch threw for one, and then scored one, and Wistrom caught a 70-yard touchdown pass from Crouch. So it's Nebraska beginning to get the momentum, and waiting for it is Keo Craver, number three, and Randy Stella. Stella is returning kicks and is listed as a linebacker.
Linebacker, running back in college and high school.
And he's got the ball right here. And out to the 25-yard line. So Randy Stella brings it out for pretty good field position. There's the record crowd we were telling you about. The last player, we were talking about Eric Crouch, the last player to pass, run, and throw for a touchdown in the same game was Jaquez Green against Auburn in 1997, on my birthday.
Jaquez Green, on your birthday. Well, you're going to have another birthday there soon there, Hawes.
Newcomb opens at quarterback, hands the ball inside to Willie Miller. Fullback, and he pops in there. Fullbacks don't get a whole lot of carries. When Joel Makovic did, he got a lot of carries, but generally speaking, he's a blocking back.
Back when Frank Solage was fullback, they got a lot of carries.
Yes, they did.
Yeah. Here's a revealing stat right here. The I-backs have rushed for 4 yards on 5 carries. The quarterbacks are doing all the rushing. They've scored 2 touchdowns rushing and 1 receiving.
This is Evans. And he'll get it up to the 30-yard line before Damian Marzette brings him down. Damian Marzette, sort of an interesting fellow. He was on his way to Texas A&M with Sir Parker, both of them having come out of Locke High School. And his mom had a heart attack, a mild heart attack, so he stayed home and went to Southwest Community College. And California never forgot about him. They watched him and kept calling him, and here he is, starting for them. Originally on his way to A&M. Newcomb down the line, penalty flag, and stepping in to make the tackle for California is Keith Miller, number 53. And we've got Delta O'Neill hobbling off the field, coming across midfield. So he was down deep and something happened, so he's dragging a foot or an ankle. But now he's looked like he's going to be able to walk it off and stay in. But for a moment, he was hurting pretty bad. Now he's coming out. They've already lost Matt Beck, yeah, who was one of their principal performers on defense, an inside linebacker. And now O'Neill has come limping off the field.
Offside on the defense. Remains third down.
Put the ball on the 35-yard line. And it's just very close to a first down, probably a foot, maybe not even that much. Newcomb just takes the snap and falls right in behind Dominic Raiola, James Sherman, and Russ Hochstein and Steen, and he's got the first down.
Here's a look. You've seen a lot of gray gloves around this year. They've been talking about for a long time having everybody wear the same color gloves because the offensive linemen would wear the color of the jersey they're playing that week so they could get their hands on it. Now it's going to be mandatory next year, but a lot of the schools are wearing them this year, the gray colored gloves that everybody must wear next season, but a lot of them are doing it now.
Newcomb pitches to Evans. Evans gives the ball away to London, Frankie London, running now for daylight, but the Bears are going to outnumber him and bring him down. Frankie London's a fellow who came here as a quarterback from Louisiana, wound up playing wide receiver and returning kicks. Pretty exciting, too. We give him a little crack, he's gone.
And I'm sure there are some things in Frank Solich's gadget box, the gimmicks with this. Frankie London's in there throwing the football also. I don't know if he needs to show anything more in this ball game. He's probably just going to. But you know, the more you show, the more it forces the other team to prepare for when you go to play somebody.
Pressure coming, steps away from one, got away, won't get away from him. The ball's out. Beanbag goes down, California's got it. Juan Jimenez comes up with a football.
Jimenez is in there playing for Matt Beck, who was injured earlier in the ball game. Big break here for the Bears.
At 17.
Newcomb just trying to get away. This is Newcomb's 4th turnover in the last 2 ball games. When you're in trouble, you got to put the ball away.
Parker and DeStefano, that free safety is still up there playing at the line of scrimmage.
Yep.
And beyond it. Makes a lot of tackles. Go the Bears, have a break. First down, just inside the Nebraska 20-yard line. Give it to Marcus Fields, trying to find some room. And Marcus Fields has discovered what an awful lot of people have discovered when they come to play football against Nebraska, that Roger Miller was right. You can't roller skate in the Buffalo herd.
Well, it's just too much speed to get around these guys. They've got linebackers that are normally defensive backs. Eric Johnson and Julius Jackson, Brian Shaw and Tony Ortiz are linebackers that run like defensive backs. Newcomb's third fumble, and he's already had an interception, so four turnovers in two ball games. Not good. Not good offense.
You got to play north-south football. Clemens pumps it. Takes off. And we'll go down to the 19 in the arms of Craver. Keo Craver, a corner coming up to get him. 28-0, as you see. Nebraska is leading. That's 7-0 in the first quarter. Then bang, bang, bang. Late in the second quarter, they have 21 points.
Steve Warren's been in the backfield more than Clemens has been back there. Nobody open downfield. He just has to get out of there.
Monty Davenport deep on this side. Davenport had a chance to make a big play earlier in the game and didn't hold on to the ball. He's looking for him, but he is tracked down from behind by Eric Johnson. Johnson, number 27.
But Johnson's main job is to contain the quarterback, and he does a nice job of keeping the quarterback inside. Here he is right here, number 27. Does a nice job of getting him down.
And we'll have a field goal try. It'll be Ignacio Brache. He missed one from 35 earlier. Now he's going to try from 42 just to get on the board. They can. And he hit the upright. That's the second time. Second time that he's hit the upright. Now, if you went out there and tried to do that, probably wear your leg out and not be able to do it. So the Bears are turned away, and it's 28-0 Huskers. Look of Memorial Stadium has been changed considerably. The outside, as you drive down the highway into town, Cornhusker Highway, doesn't look like a football stadium. It looks like a big fancy building, and it is, because these have been added. There's the media facility that was named today in honor of Donald William Bryant. He's going to come visit us in a little while. But a lot of that space there are luxury boxes. 42 luxury boxes opened here today at a cost of about $36 million. That gives the Big 12 Conference a total of 319, with more coming next year. So the support of the people of the Big 12 Conference and their willingness to pay for luxury suites is making an enormous difference in a lot of ways.
And they didn't only build a nice building, a big building. They built a nice building. It's very comfortable. They did it right in every sense of the word.
I think it's the best facility I've ever seen.
That's only because you've got your name over here on your facility, your bathroom facility.
Private restroom.
Only booth I've ever been in where we have a bathroom facility, and they just named it today the Keith Jackson Toilet Facility, dedicated September 11th, 1999.
You should thank me. And Bill Byrne, the athletic director here. Ball rolling around inside the 20. Tonight it's primetime college football on ABC. The UCLA Bruins and the Ohio State Buckeyes will have it at the Horseshoe in Columbus. That'll be a good ball game, though the Bruins are without 11 players who have been suspended. And then you've got another one going tonight that's going to be echoing all the rest of the year as well. And that will be in the ACC with Georgia Tech and Florida State. So check your local listings. It's scheduled for 8 Eastern and 5 Pacific on ABC Sports.
It's been a long time since Ohio State looked at going 0-2.
Oh boy.
At the start of a season.
Certainly has. It is third down and 15 now. And Bobby Newcomb whistles one. Close. No. Trapped it. intended for Matt Davison. We talk about these luxury suites. Texas has 66 and thinking about more. But Texas A&M started it all back in 1948. The Aggies are going to add 20 more next year. So there's a lot of folks having a lot of good fun today in relatively comfortable circumstances in the Big 8 Conference.
And well, they should.
And it does not involve taxpayer money now. I mean, let's get that out in front. It's there, so they pay for themselves. That's a spinner, low line drive going to O'Neill, who's apparently walked off that sore ankle, but he's got a problem right here. Oh, he got a good block and got around the corner, almost, not quite. He got up across the 30 when he could have been gone at about the 23, 24. Dre Harris tried to pick him a block and get him going, but couldn't do it. 7:50 to go in the third quarter. Here comes Kyle Bowler, who is being hyped considerably in the Bay Area as the salvation of the leader of the future for California's offense. He is a big fella. He was the California Football Player of the Year at the high school level from Hart out of Newhall. And he's very good. Big arm, very accomplished for his age. This is Salim Muhammad trying to sweep in. And like we said a while ago, you're not going to do much east and west against Nebraska.
Now, Bowler, Keith, had stupendous numbers, 59 touchdown passes, only 3 interceptions. Now, those are numbers in high school, so you don't know who he's playing against and all that other stuff.
He's playing a pretty good league.
Yeah, well, that's pretty good numbers.
Yep. Whistled. Got an arm, Bob.
Yeah, he can throw it.
Here's Todd Harris with some news on Mr. Bowler.
Thank you, Keith. Well, the folks at Cal are hoping that Bowler grows mentally as fast as he did physically. Freshman year of high school, he was about 5'5". By the time he was a senior in high school, he's about 5'11". Freshman year at Cal, he checks in at 6'4". So some rapid growth there. They're hoping the same thing happens up top.
Well, he may very well wind up playing at about 6'5 and 230 pounds, too. You know, he's got a big frame. And he is a freshman. Oh, look at this. That, folks, is tall seasoning. Carlos Polk took him down.
Yeah. That's the fourth sack today by a Nebraska player. And the first sack of Bowler. He's got a lot of physical talent, but the mental stuff, just being a freshman, they're going to come out and blitz you. Polk gets right up and beats one of the guys at the line of scrimmage. No chance on that one.
And Nick Harris is in the punt. This will be number 6 on the day. Oh, the block. Penalty flag was thrown just before the snap. Brian Shaw comes in to block it. But let's see about the flag thrown over on the near sideline. The ball is at the 13-yard line.
Illegal formation on the kicking team. 6 men on the line of scrimmage. First down.
He comes right up the middle. This is Shaw right here, number 46. He's going to come right in, and the two guys in front of him don't touch him.
Wow.
That's just good coaching by Nebraska. They saw something in the film study. They lined him up properly, and they got the man right up the gut. The easiest place to block a punt from is right up the middle.
Eric Crouch is the quarterback now. D'Angelo Evans, the eye back, and up the middle he goes. That's his best run of the day. James Sherman gave him some help and escorted him down to the 6-yard line.
This is only the third time that Crouch has been in at quarterback. The other 7 times, Bobby Newcomb has been behind center. But Crouch has been much more productive. The two other times he was at quarterback, they scored. And one of the other times he was in, he caught a touchdown pass.
Fullback gets it this time. And the big fellow Willie Miller. As the penalty flag goes down, we'll have about a yard on the carry. Jeff Ronnie, who was another of the quarterbacks here, has transferred. He's going down to Nebraska Omaha and try to play down there. That you sometimes you get so many people at one position, and sometimes you're better off if you go someplace else.
Yeah.
It's a holding call against Nebraska. ABC Sports presentation of college football brought to you by the Pontiac Sunfire. Hot set of wheels, money left to burn. National Car Rental. So what are you waiting for? Let's go. And Morgan Stanley, Dean Witter. We measure success one investor at a time. Well, you look at things for the Cornhuskers, they're going to need a lot of depth before this Big 12 season's over, because there's some tough cookies in this conference now. And some who are getting tougher.
Quarterback draw didn't do too well there.
No, it did not. Andre Carter is the guy who stuffed it. But Frank Solich made the point yesterday in conversation with him, Bob, that this, for one thing, the Big 12 championship game, plus the other opportunities that exist, plus the simple growth of things, that making it a Big 12 conference has made it a tougher conference.
Oh, no question about that. And you can't play everybody in the conference, but yet Nebraska has drawn all four of the other top contenders to win the crown in the Big 12.
Yep, they got to play all the tough nuts. They pitch it out, pitch it behind D'Angelo Evans. That's a bad pitch. And he covers it back around the 20-yard line. At the conclusion of today's games, we'll pick a Chevy player of the game. Chevrolet making a contribution to each university's general scholarship fund. And beginning this year, Chevrolet will also make a donation to each player's high school. I think that's a good idea. Josh Brown is in now for a field goal try. This will be his first collegiate field goal. He's a redshirt freshman from Foyle, Oklahoma. He's trying to succeed Chris Brown. And he looked pretty good on that. 37 yards down the highway. And it's 31-0. The Cornhuskers over the California Bears. The Cornhuskers and kicking off to Chidi Iwoma and LaShawn Ward. Delta O'Neill does in fact have a sore ankle and is not out there. Dan Haydenfeld pops it. Well, he's got a leg, doesn't he?
Wow.
Beyond the field of play it goes. Iwoma backing up out of the end zone to make the catch. It'll come out for the 21st down, California. Marcus Fields had a pretty good week last week against Rutgers. He ran for 123 of California's 162 yards on the ground, but today the yardage on the ground has been small indeed. He has 14 carries in the ball game and only 28 yards. Bowler's the quarterback. Threw it very hard. Receiver couldn't come up with it. Ryan Surgeon of the tight end. It was thrown hard and low.
Kyle Bowler's got a gun for an arm, and the word on him is he doesn't move around as well as some other quarterbacks, so he's going to be a pocket passer. But if he gets protection and he knows what he's doing as far as who's blocked and who isn't, he can survive just staying in a pocket.
Timeout call by California.
They say Bowler only played 1 year in high school quarterback. He was a safety his junior year. And then had that big year. He and Chris Sims, who ended up going to the University of Texas, were commonly considered the two top quarterbacks in the country.
talking to Frank Solich and looking at his circumstance now in his second year following the people he followed. He knows it's tough, and he had this comment about it.
You follow Bob Devaney and the career that he had. You follow Tom, who won more games in 25 years than any coach in college ball in the history of it. You know, the expectations are going to be there. I understand that. I've got no problems with that, and look forward to it.
The other part of it is, he comes every time he comes out here to the stadium or comes to the office, he sees this massive expanse of glass and steel and luxury boxes and all of that stuff. And you know as well as I do, that says win, baby.
Yeah, exactly. And he took over a winning program and a very good program that he was a part of for 19 years as an assistant.
And before that, a player. There's a penalty flag on the field as LaShawn Ward is working hard and gets out across the 30-yard line. That's a heck of a run.
That's a hell of a run for a 7-yard gain.
Ward is another fellow that's been is capable of going both ways for California. And then after that, all that effort, they're going to lose it because of
illegal formation. Six men on the line of scrimmage. Repeat, second down.
That's the second time that they've been hit with that call,
yeah,
too.
I think he outran about half the defense. Let's count the red jerseys here. There's Finley, number 19. He misses. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Seventh one got a piece of him and got him down. That's Brown, of course.
That's 10 flags on the Bears for 88 total yards so far today. Bowler throws it, and it comes right back in his face as Kyle Vandenbosch, big old defensive end, was looming.
Vandenbosch, we haven't heard much from him today, but it's a little defensive game. Here's Vandenbosch. The tackle's going to come out this way, and Vandenbosch is going to come around. It's a little trick they use to foul up the blocking assignments of the offensive lineman, and that's, geez, that's almost not fair. I mean, geez. Guy that big, they call him the Mad German. He's got about a 3.8 grade point average. Somebody's got to lay a hat on him at least. Mm.
Down the middle of the field, and it'll go incomplete. Ward, the intended receiver. Penalty flag.
No play.
No play.
Dead ball foul. Delay of the game on the offense. Repeat, third down.
Well, they were going to make sure that Vandenbosch didn't get in on him this time. Let's take a look at this. That's deal number 60. Vandenbosch makes a move to the inside. I got you by the neck and the face mask.
Oh, man. And the call was no play. If there had been a play, there probably would have been a face mask call. But it was a dead ball. That's going to be picked off. That might go for 6. Ralph Brown. Down to the 1-yard line. Now they're going to say he hit the chalk at about 3 or 4.
Maybe a freshman playing in his second game, but Ralph Brown is starting his 41st game. Top right of your screen, number 22, has good vision on the quarterback and the experience of the fourth-year senior starting every game since he's been in Nebraska. That's an easy pick for him.
He growling because he didn't get in the end zone.
He wanted to get there.
Crouch, quarterback. Little step back, turns it up, runs through the hole, and scores 6. That's his third touchdown. He threw for 1 and ran 2 in. been involved in three touchdowns today. The man shaken up on the field for California is Chidi Iwoma. Bears are probably getting a little tired now.
Well, Nebraska's defense set that up. The interception of... And Tom Homo knows that he wants to get this young freshman some experience in there. Get him in, let him make some mistakes. Game's out of hand.
They're looking at his knee. This was an easy run for Crouch, Bob.
This is one of his easier ones, right? He could be he could play tailback. Of course, in this offense, this option offense, it really opens a lot of things for the quarterback running the football.
Iwoma's coming off. He's walking all right, so let's hope he's okay. It's been a tough start on the year in 1999 for the Pac-10. And UCLA is in battling upstream at Columbus, Ohio tonight.
Yeah, they're in deep water up there, aren't they?
Mm-hmm. Josh Brown, well, with all those suspensions. Josh Brown for the point. It's good. 38-0. The Nebraska Cornhuskers now starting to roll.
Eric Crouch was the ABC player of the game last week at Iowa.
Tonight we're going to buy him supper.
Yep. No, you can't do that, Hoss. Here's his touchdown run, his first one. Here's a fake option pass to Wistrom.
70 yards.
Then he's going to come in motion as a flanker, as a wide receiver, and catch a little short jailbreak screen. How many yards is this one?
60.
And then he just ran in the other touchdown. He's had four touchdowns on the day. He scored three and threw one. Not a bad day for him. Now think if they weren't using the two quarterback system. When Solich announced that he was going to start Newcomb a while back, if he hadn't been playing Eric Crouch, all this production would not have been there. These coaches know what they're doing, don't they?
That'll come out to the 20. Tuesday, September 21st, Heather Locklear joins the cast of Spin City, plus Yankee All-Star Roger Clemens guest stars on the season premiere of Spin City. That's Tuesday, September 21.
Next to those guys in that. See that big?
Yep, Clemens? Big guy. And those other folks are little folks.
Yeah, they look little folks.
They are. On first down from the 20. This is Salim Muhammad. Talking about Eric Crouch, and we might as well, because he has been quite outstanding today, to say the least. On his play, his use in the ball game as a wideout. He doesn't fear it because he has a background for that sort of thing. Here was his brief comment.
Ever since I was, you know, third grade running back, that's what I started off as, a running back, and I've always, you know, been physical and tried to make the best plays out of everything.
I would say he's reached a new level today. Second down and 8.
Well, both Crouch and Newcomb came to Nebraska at the same time. They're the same age. Newcomb was not redshirted, and Crouch was. So Crouch is a redshirt sophomore. Newcomb is a true junior.
I think you can see here, too, what Tom Homo and his staff are doing. They've got Salim Muhammad in there at the tailback position now, and he's carried three or four times. And now here comes Joe Igber. Oh, here he is. The fuse is lit. Almost. He was a half a step from popping out of there, and Jeremy Schlechter got him. But he got a first down. And California will keep the football, and Igbert comes out, and Muhammad goes back. Bonnie Davenport goes in for the Bears. Now Nebraska's beginning to rest some people as well. That is the first down of the half for California.
This is their fourth possession. The first three, they were three plays and out.
Second units across the board for the Cornhuskers on defense. From the 33-yard line, that kind of stuff is not going much. Jason Lohr out of Springfield, Missouri, makes the tackle. The California Golden Bears, now they drew 33,000 people for Rutgers in their home opener. Last year, Nebraska came to town, and the Bears played them a pretty good ball game, too. They sold the place out for Nebraska. Now California's talking to Michigan for a five-year deal, two games in Berkeley and three games in Ann Arbor early in the season. Well, you take a chance when you do that.
They'll sell out all five of those games.
You betcha. That's an incomplete forward pass. Double coverage on Michael Ainsworth, a redshirt freshman who was running under the ball. California's total yards in the first quarter, they had 73. Since that time, with 16 seconds to play in the third quarter, they have gained 43.
The Nebraska defense, the black shirts, are back. Charlie McBride has got this group. They'll be back near the top in the national rankings for sure.
Third down and 8 from the 35. This is Ainsworth, and he will have a first down.
It's a nice
came out.
Yeah, nice play by the defensive back there. Didn't get his number.
Gross, number 5. Ball came out, and the Huskers jumped all over it. Brian Shaw covered it for Nebraska.
It's a good job by the defensive back. Gross, watch him. He's going to get beat, but he's going to catch up. And then he's going to knock the ball out. Right here, he comes around with his arm. Good heads-up play by Gross.
And Shaw covered.
They actually work on that. They have these drills defensive backs do about knocking the ball out of the receiver's hands. And it helps the receivers try and hold on to it.
It's not fair. This is Dan Alexander, who has not played much. He had a little bit of a sore knee coming off practice, but he's 245 pounds, and when he gets rolling, he's a load. Third quarter is over. 38-0 Huskers. ABC Sports presentation of college football returns after this message and a word from our ABC stations. 38-0 as we go into the final quarter of play, with the Nebraska Cornhuskers being in utter control of the football game now. And they own the football, second down and 7 on the California 47-yard line. And this is Big Dan Alexander rolling for a Husker first down, and here's Todd Harris.
Well, a wise football man once said it's the big uglies that win these big games. And in Nebraska, as we all know, they've got plenty of those. But their weight program is designed for both the big men and the finesse men. And Boyd Epley, the director of athletic training, told me he's got these kids in the weight room 3 weeks after their bowl game. They get right after it. Each player is monitored individually to a point that the athlete doesn't complete his program until his card is signed by a supervisor that he witnesses the final rep. So it's serious business here. The final result, dominating football. Keith.
And that ball thrown very well and caught by Matt Davison. Davison goes out of bounds right about the 20-yard line for another Nebraska first down, and they're down knocking on the door again.
Some of the beneficiaries of that weight room, Keith, are the offensive linemen, as you well know.
Well, these wide receivers lift a lot, too, because over the years that I've been coming here, and that's a lot of years, the white wingbacks and wideouts on Nebraska football teams block.
Yeah.
They don't play.
There's your offensive line gaining over 100 pounds in the bench press from the time they get there to the time they are right here, right now.
Let's catch up on late news from New York. John Saunders.
Keith, the Win Your Way Burger King update. A great game between Purdue and Notre Dame. Jerry's Jackson, 4-5 for 57 yards on this drive. Here to Bobby Brown. They cap it with the extra point. Take a 23-22 lead. Still in the third quarter. Keith.
Wow, that's hard stuff. You realize who I'm sitting by, John.
Hail, hail to old Purdue.
He's in trouble because he's got to go to Denver and watch his youngin' make his first start in the National Football League on Monday, and now you're telling him his Boilers are down by a point.
That's right.
Oh,
dead
me.
Ball. False start on the offense. 5-yard penalty. Still second down.
Got to wiggle along the line from Damian Bauman. Second down and 16 here at Memorial Stadium in Lincoln. Been a kind of a gray day, but it's been a good day for football because we started it with 68 degrees, and I don't think it's gone above that. And there is going to be some rain later, but it's certainly more comfortable for everybody at 68 degrees than it might have been at 88, which is kind of where it's been on many days immediately in front of the game. So Bobby Newcomb back now on second and long. Throws complete to Frankie London. London is inside the 10 and down at about the 6-yard line.
I think they're saying his knee was down around the 20-yard line.
The referee standing there looking at it and got his hand up in the arm up in the air, so it must be so.
Yeah, his knee hit the ground. Good and shot, guys.
Just inside the 20-yard line.
Yeah.
Kelly Hayes saw that.
Kelly did, didn't he?
Yes, he did. I was about to be living in that high mountain air, soaring, sailing windjammers off the coast of Scotland. Timeout called by Nebraska. 12:51 to play in the football game. Huskers call the timeout. It's a 38-0 ball game. Nebraska has the lead. And a little while ago at halftime, we had a special presentation here at what is now being called the media facility. That's Bill Byrne, the athletic director, in the middle, Donald William Bryant, better known as the Fox to several million friends around the world. And it will hereafter be known as the Don Bryant Media Facility. Congratulations, Fox.
Thank you very much, Keith. It's a great thrill, and it's great to have you here to take part in it. And we're glad to always have you here. You know that.
Well, pull up a chair and let's watch the rest of the ball game and talk some about the days. You've been here for so long, for so many years, and known so many people and seen so many great games and all of that. So get back to the field here as the Huskers hunker down and see if they can stick it in for one more. They've got about all they need at 38-0, and Bobby Newcomb will handle them in front. But you came here what?
Right after Bob Devaney's first season, 1962.
And you know, you did play some, didn't you? You wore the leather helmet.
Well, just about. We didn't have a face mask, I'll tell you that.
That looks like leather to me.
Yeah, there we go. See, no face mask.
Very few lines in the face of you nor Devaney. And then as the years have gone on, that trademark red flat coat, and there'll be one of those put in a case here too. So that the people never forget the number of footsteps you put on this this great old place. But it's an incredible facility now, isn't it?
It really is. Of course, we've all been in a lot of press boxes, but this is one of the greatest ones, and certainly the biggest.
Let's take a break here, and we'll come right back. So here's a timeout with a score 38-0. And 8 for the Nebraska Cornhuskers as they come back to the ball, and there's somebody having a good time. If it rains, though, there'll be a mess. 4th and 8. Bobby Newcomb sets them up. Flips it out. Goes to Alexander, and he stopped short of his first down. Making the play is Damian Marzette. And there's a penalty flag in the aftermath.
face mask.
So if that's the case, then it'll be against California, and Sanico is the one who's walking around feeling badly about it, arguing a little bit, not much. And it's probably called on Marzette for the tackle, and that'll give Nebraska a first down. We're getting down here in territory for a memory for both of us, Don Bryant, when we're down in Norman, Oklahoma, 1979, when the Huskers are in a tough one against a tough Oklahoma team, and they laid the ball on the ground, and a big old guard named Randy Slushny picked it up and ran it in for a touchdown.
That's right, the old fumble rooski.
The Ooski business, you know, when Bobby Bowden used it at Clemson in a game, everybody sort of had the feeling that it was invented back there, but it wasn't. It came, Tom found those plays and from some high school.
High school coach had used it. He saw it on film when he was recruiting, looking at recruiting film.
Alexander bangs it into the end zone, and Nebraska adds another touchdown. What's your sense of this football team? You've seen a lot of them now.
Well, it's been kind of a strange game. It started out with some errors by both sides, and then a long punt kind of turned the tide. And,
but you've never had a team where the two quarterbacks were the dominant people.
I was going to say, I don't think I've ever seen where the number one quarterback threw a touchdown pass to the number two quarterback. And so I don't know. It's a unique game.
It's almost as if the I-backs are being de-emphasized and the quarterbacks are getting all the touchdowns and all the yardage.
Well, as few rushing yards as there are, it's very unusual around here. Usually we've got a lot more than that.
Yeah.
Well, the I-backs have very little today. 45 to nothing now. And let's go back to that story we were talking about in 79 when Tom Osborne, who, though conservative perhaps in his appearance and his behavior, was a riverboat gambler when it came to coaching offensive football. And there's big old Randy Slushner, the guard, picking up the loose ball and slamming it in. But despite the play, Oklahoma won the game 17-14.
Yeah, we did. We could have run it one more time, maybe.
Is it the legend that makes it so, or is it really true that that 71 Oklahoma-Nebraska game was the best of the ball?
Well, for me personally, it's the most exciting game I was ever around, and I think it's because we were one, they were two, and in a game like that, you expect to get a great game, and we all got it. I mean, they were a tremendous bunch of kids that played at Oklahoma, and our kids were good, and it was just two fine football teams that produced a great national championship at that point game, and that's always been my favorite.
And ball kicked out of bounds. It'll be a penalty on it. What is it now? You were the marketing guy. You were the salesman. You were the creator. Is there such a thing to be considered as a Nebraska mystique?
Well, I think there is from the standpoint of if you look back in the 20s and the 30s and the Depression years, the people in Nebraska loved the university, loved the athletic department, the football team. But it's been the only major school, the major sports attraction in the state for generations, and everybody wanted their kids to grow up and go to the University of Nebraska and be a Cornhusker, and I think all that plays into it through the year.
Kind of interesting that in this particular game, though the game is out of hand as far as the Golden Bears are concerned, but California, you know, has been playing football 117 years and Nebraska 109 years. So these are two old whiteheads when it comes to college football. And represent a lot of things because there's as much talk on both these campuses about academics, I think, as there is about athletics.
That's right. It's stressed here, and I'm sure it's stressed out there. That's a great educational institution, and we sure think this is too. And I've got great affection for Colorado, California. After at the end of the war there in 46, I was out in California in the Frisco area. And got to see the Golden Bears, Pappy Waldorf and Jackie Jensen. And I learned to love that California alma mater song.
You know, the Jackie Jensen in 1966, when we got the package back at ABC and I went down to do a Duke Clemson game, Jackie Jensen was my color man.
Yeah. Good guy.
Gone on to great fame as a home run hitter for the Red Sox.
Good football player.
Well, your sense then is that even though Frank Solich knows that he's facing a turnover one of these years in his coaching staff because of some of these George and Milton and Charlie, one of these days, are going to go fishing.
That's right.
About that time.
Their hair is turning gray.
And there will be some turnover, but the stability of the coaching staff speaks well for the whole program.
I think that's been a key factor through the years, the Devaney's guys and Tom's, and it's helped. No doubt about it.
Well, Bob Devaney came here after having ridden the rails and gone to the South and made a little money and gotten a couple of bare knuckle jobs to eat supper and traveling up and down, and finally landed here at Nebraska after a stint at Wyoming and started the whole thing. Don Bryant was very much a part of it, and over the years made 100 million friends, and we're proud that they're going to put your name on the wall here.
Well, thank you very much, Keith.
Don, I got to ask you before you go, there's another name on the wall back here. I mean, tell us about this back here, this name back here.
Well, we have this new, I only had one responsibility, and that was to keep Keith Jackson and you happy.
Yeah.
And I have no other power here anymore.
So the name's on the John right behind us.
When we had a new John put in here, and it's the Keith Jackson relief station.
Okay.
Oh, boy. 45-0, Nebraska has this one put away. Diedrich is in at an I-back position now for Nebraska. And Jeff Perino is in at quarterback for Nebraska. Jeff is a senior out of Durango, Colorado, number three in the pecking order at that position.
That's probably his mama right there, all excited because he's getting in the ball game.
And this is Diedrich. And he is a freshman from Scarborough, Ontario. And he just broke a big play all the way out to the 40-yard line. ABC Sports presentation of college football brought to you by Chrysler, engineered to be great cars. Dell, innovative computer solutions from the company that pioneered direct around the world. Be direct, Dell. Valvoline, you can always tell the guys who use Valvoline. And National Thrifty Car Rental, the car you want, the service you expect, all at a low rate. Just what you want, just Thrifty. Do you have any power on your side? Things are giving up here.
I think one of the reasons Diedrich is in the ball game, Keith, is because Buckhalter, who was the number three running back and actually started eight ball games last year at IBAC, was suspended for this ball game only for missing 3 days of practice this week.
Well, his heart was broken.
Yeah, he was a little upset that he didn't get to play more last week.
After having led the team in rushing last year, the tackle is made on Ben Kingston, and he's rolled backwards, but he's down as the ball comes out. But the circumstance is such that you always feel that you never have too many running backs.
Oh, that's for sure.
And that's what happened last year. Two guys go down,
exactly.
And Buckhalter get the chance to play a lot.
Yeah, he gained over 800 yards last year for the Huskers, and he was the guy. And then this year, the other two guys come back healthy, both Evans and Alexander. And last week, he carries like three times in a mop-up situation up in Iowa.
Marino going around the corner. That's a first down. So Nebraska is cleaning the bench. Everybody's playing, and they just keep on rolling because California by now is pretty well worn out. Well, let's go back to our Dell Game Solutions now as we started.
Well, Nebraska, we said that they throw to set up the run, and they've done that very nicely. They've thrown two long touchdown passes and defensively forced the young quarterbacks for Cal to win it, and they only have 99 yards passing. This is the second straight shutout for Nebraska's defense. They still have not allowed anybody to score on this year.
Barrett still got some spunk in him, though, as Diedrich tries to wiggle off the left side, and they jump in and take him down.
You know, as good as the quarterbacks have looked for Solich and the Huskers, I think there is some concern about the I-backs and the running backs. They're not getting the yards that this offense is set up for them to get. I mean, Evans has not come back from the injuries. He's not gained a lot of yardage. I mean, the quarterbacks are getting the yardage, they're getting the plays, but it's not the I-backs, and this is where the system is set up for.
loose. And they're going to call him down right there.
Fumble on the play. Going out of bounds.
They've outscored their opponents, but the two opponents that they have played, the offenses for both Cal and Iowa were near the bottom offensively in all of Division I football last year. They were at least, I think Iowa was 106th offensively and Cal was 102nd. So I think and Nebraska is has what, Southern Miss up next, I believe.
Yeah.
We test a little bit more against them.
Southern Miss walloped Tulane in their opening game, scored 48 points on them.
Yeah.
Tomorrow on ABC, 1 of 5 was Tom Watson in his opening.
At 66.
66.
You said 6,600. That'd be a hell of a round.
It certainly would. Yes. Shot 66. Hale Irwin is not in it, but they'll be bumping heads next week. There's a high hanging punt, trying to kill it deep. He pounces on the 5, and they'll put it down inside the 10. Aaron Galladay coming down.
A little golf out here yesterday. Who is this? That's my partner.
That's a bad swing. That's what that is. That's a pull left.
It's a pull left. That's a push right.
It's a push right.
No, it's hooking in. It hooked in. Yeah.
This is what happens when you hit it off the field turf now, because some of this stuff, I understand, is some driving ranges. They're using this material.
You can't hurt this stuff.
Because the ball just sits there and you whack it. You don't take a divot. You get a little sand pop up, and that's it.
I'm very impressed with this field, Keith. This stuff, you know, you put this stuff inside the dome stadiums, and I think the players all around the league, in college and pros and everybody, would be very happy with this.
Well, if it means reducing injuries and burns and all of that kind of stuff, I'm all for it.
Yeah.
We have had some injuries today, but that may very well come from the fact it's big, fast people running into each other,
yeah,
too. Second down and 7 now, with 6 minutes and 24 seconds to play for California. The Bears will have a week off to lick their wounds and try to pull things back together in a little tighter knot with a record of 1-1. And then they will be playing Arizona State, which is a pretty good team out west.
And here's what Nebraska has next week.
Going down to Missouri, and historically the Cornhuskers have had a lot of misery down in Columbia.
Well, they have to go to Missouri, to Texas, and at Colorado. And they have Kansas State and A&M both at home here.
Maybe the only 6-0 game Nebraska's had in the last half century was played in Columbia, Missouri, a few years ago. And I think it might have been against Al Onofrio's team. Joel Young makes that catch up around the 20-yard line, and if it's good, and it is, it'll be a first down for California.
The guys at the halftime show, Terry Bowden and John Saunders, were talking about the celebration rule, Keith, and the call that was made in the Notre Dame game, the Michigan-Notre Dame game. And Terry was on one side. I don't agree with Terry. I think they need the rule. I know what he's saying about, you know, let the kids celebrate and have some fun. And that's not what the NCAA is trying to legislate against. I think it's the obscene gestures. It's the self-promoting gestures. You can celebrate when you score a touchdown. All you have to do is turn around and find somebody, one of your teammates, to jump up on, and you can celebrate all you want. But this act of showing off and drawing attention to yourself with the crowd, or intimidating the opposing player, you know, there's no place in college football.
There's a definite difference, and you don't have to be very smart to see it. Big difference between celebrating and showboating.
Yeah.
Yeah. And I agree with you. Showboating has no place in the game. When you're out there, you do the best you can on a given day, and some days it's not very good. And you don't deserve to have some smart aleck shaking his finger in your face and showing off at your expense.
Now I just, you know, I'm all for keeping the enthusiasm in the game and celebrating, letting the kid be happy and show it. Just show it with the rest of your teammates. Don't Don't try and be a hot dog. I mean, when you run in that end zone and you start to high-fiving and doing fancy dances and all that other strutting and all that other stuff, you're turning your back on 10 other teammates that helped you get in that end zone.
Right. Joseph Etchema, number 18 in the ball game now, as California's letting everybody get a chance to play some. And Kyle Buller will go down, sacked behind the 15-yard line, and that is the fifth time the California quarterback has been sacked in the game. And it's Randy Stella, the guy who was returning kicks a while ago, who made that sack. So the depth of Nebraska is still here.
34 just gets around the fullback there trying to block him. That was just poor execution. They had five sacks against Cal last week and five more this week. They were the worst protecting their quarterback in the Pac-10 last year.
Nick Harris runs it back to the 40-yard line, and the ball hits the ground. California covers it. There will be a penalty flag on the field. He had to give him 2 yards room to catch the ball.
Well, his own man hit him.
And we got two flags laying there. There was no fair catch involved.
5 yard buffer zone violation, 5 yard penalty, first down.
So the rules say you got to give him 2 yards clearance to catch the ball, and they didn't. So with 3:38 to play in the ball game, Nebraska has this one in the cooler, 45-0. Sunday on ESPN, the season opener of Sunday Night Football. And guess what? Davis and the two-man defending Super Bowl champion Denver Broncos will battle the Miami Dolphins. 30th anniversary season of Monday Night Football at 9 Eastern Time on ABC Sports. And my partner Bob Greasy is going off to Denver to watch the game. Oh, I wonder why.
I got some connections on both sides, and I can't get anybody to give me any information. I got Jimmy Johnson. He thinks I'm, you know, got some affiliation with the Broncos. He won't talk to me. And I got Brian, my son. He's starting for the Broncos. He thinks I'm a Dolphin fan, so he won't tell me anything either. So I don't know any more than anybody else.
Do you have to buy your own ticket?
Well, I did get in the ball game. I told him that. I wouldn't invite him home for Christmas.
Just tell the youngin' not to be nervous. Just go on out there and play hard.
I don't think he wants to hear anything from me. I think he thinks when I played, it was in the old days.
Bobby Newcomb, we've talked a lot about Eric Crouch, and you've seen him do all kinds of things today, which tells you his worth to this team. Well, Bobby Newcomb is another quarterback here in Nebraska who feels like he's got talent in several areas, and in including returning kicks. His coach even says he may be one of the very best in the country. And sitting and talking to him, I said, Bobby, you're not serious. Now, you wouldn't go out there as the starting quarterback and want to be returning kicks. And this is what he told
me. I can return punts, and Coach Holtz has been working with me in practice on returning punts. We haven't seen any game yet, but he might sneak me in there for, you know, one or two this weekend.
Well, they haven't needed it this weekend.
They haven't needed it, but Frank told me last week that he is by far the best punt returner on this Nebraska ball club, and said, in fact, he may be the best in the nation.
Well, I asked him if he really thought he could do that, and he said, yes, I do. I fully believe I can do both in a game.
I believe that he can too. I think Crouch could too, the way I've seen him running.
There was Perino keeping the ball, and he looks pretty quick himself. We told you that Jay Runty had transferred. He's going down to Nebraska, Omaha, so he can get a chance to play some, because they're pretty well populated at the quarterback position. But I think it's kind of an interesting thing, and I'll bet you it's something that the offensive side of the coaching staff, Bob, sits down and does some serious thinking about. That the tradition of the I-back being a hammer in the Nebraska offense is simply not there at this time.
That's got to be a concern. There's no question in my mind that, you know, you like to have everything working for you. And one thing that is not up to speed in this offense are the I-backs.
Yeah. Dan Haydenfeld was up in the huddle and then came running out to go into punt position. And I guess they called their last timeout. Maybe they have one left. A minute 50 to play in the ball game, and if time permits, we invite you to stay tuned for the Thrifty Car Rental postgame report. It was on one, but I guess that's legal. But you
I'm
know,
glad we didn't see that, because you would have really you would have stood up and got on your high horse. Sam.
You're talking about the rules committee looking for something to do. Now I kind of thought that was looking for something to do. The bandana rule.
There you go. There's the bandana.
Yep. But you can't see it once he puts his helmet on. Not supposed to see it.
You can.
That's the new kind of a bandana.
Yeah.
Ball is going to roll dead, and they're going to let it roll around and die somewhere down inside the 10-yard line. And here is this message from the NCAA. Something didn't roll, huh? Ball is on the 9-yard line for California now. It's simply a matter, it has been for the whole fourth quarter, running out the clock and playing the game to its end. And the both coaches' staff playing everybody they can to get him in the ball game and let him get a feel of playing a football game. Now we can tell you that today's Chevrolet players of the game are Andre Carter for California. Andre had 8 tackles and 2 sacks today from his defensive end position for the Bears. And Eric Crouch for Nebraska, who ran for 21 yards and 2 touchdowns, who passed for 102 yards and a touchdown, and caught a pass for 60 yards and a touchdown. And in recognition of their effort, Chevrolet will make a $1,000 contribution to each university's general scholarship fund. And beginning this year, Chevrolet also donates $1,000 to the high schools of the two players. For Andre Carter, it's Oak Grove High School in San Jose, California. And for Eric Crouch, Millard North in Omaha, Nebraska.
Ball carried by number 29.
Well, Eric did not win the starting quarterback job, but he has won the player of the week 2 weeks in a row.
How about that?
Way to go, Eric.
That tells you something, doesn't it?
Yep. Nebraska has played 83 players, California 53. They didn't bring as many, obviously. Newcomb was 3 of 7 passing for 85 yards, and Crouch was 2 of 2. He only threw 2 passes, 102 yards and a touchdown. So that's the quarterback comparison for the Huskers.
That could very well be the last play of the ball game, as the clock is going to tick off and the Nebraska Cornhuskers remain undefeated. They came into the ball game ranked number 6 in the national polls. And they'll stay there or better themselves, probably move up a couple of notches as they beat the California Bears by a final score of 45-0. And we'll be right back to tell you about some bonus coverage in college football after this break.
I never dreamed until.
If you enjoyed it, wasn't much of a ball game after the third quarter as Nebraska dominated. ABC Sports is online at ESPN.com, part of the Go Network. This has been a presentation of ABC Sports, continuing the tradition of excellence. Now let's join John Saunders and Terry Bowden.